Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 3.1 that is taken from chapter number 3, Mechanical Properties of the Materials, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement of the problem is a tension test for steel alloy result in stress strain diagram as shown in figure 3-18. Calculate the modulus of elasticity and the yield strength based on 0.2% offset. Identify on the graph the ultimate stress and the fracture stress. So you can see this is the tensile test specimen, and tensile test is conducted, and as a result the stress strain diagram for this tensile test is shown over here. This is the real tensile test stress strain graph, while this is the magnified stress strain diagram till this region. Clear? Because you can see here we cannot identify the strain values, therefore they have given the magnified stress strain diagram till the point of yielding, and their strains are given in the blue color data. These are the strain for this till the point of yielding. So you have to determine the modulus of elasticity and the yield strength based on the 0.2% offset. Identify on the graph the ultimate strength and fracture. So let's start with the solution. So first we will find the modulus of elasticity. So I will write modulus of elasticity, and this modulus of elasticity can be obtained from the slope of the initial straight line of the graph. So you can see this is the slope of initial line of the graph that is exaggerated or magnified. So using magnified curve and scale shown in this blue color text, this line extends from point O to A and to estimated point A dash. This is magnified line. So which has coordinate of approximately, the coordinates are on x-axis, the coordinate is, you can see this blue color, 0.00016, and on y-axis the coordinate of this line, OA line. Let me choose this black color. This OA line, the coordinate will be 50, y-coordinate will be 50. So the slope of this line will be equal to modulus of elasticity, and this modulus of elasticity will be equal to y coordinate, which is 50 KSI. So 50 KSI divided by the x coordinate, which is 0.0016, and it is given in inch per inch. So when you calculate it, you will get the modulus of elasticity of this stress strain curve comes out to be 31.2 into 10 to the power 3 KSI. So this is the modulus of elasticity. Note that this equation of line, we can also write equation of line OA will be sigma is equal to 31.2 into 10 to the power 3 multiply by strain. This will be the equation of line OA. How? Because we know that equation of line is y is equal to mx plus c, where y here is represented as stress and x represent epsilon. So m is slope, m is equal to slope. And the slope of this line is, we have calculated as E. And C is the y-intercept. Here C is equal to 0, because you can see it starts from the origin. So from this equation, if I put Y as sigma, M is E, and X is epsilon, and C is equal to 0. So this will be this equation, and E is 31.2 into 10 to the power 3 multiply by epsilon will be the equation of line OA, which is the same over here. Now what will be the yield strength based on 0.2% offset? So let me write it. yield strength based on 0.2% offset. So 0.2% offset means that it is 0.002 strain. Clear? Okay, this is strain, 0.002 strain. So what you can see here, that if I choose this 0.002, which is this one, this is 0.2% strain that is already given at this point. So from this point, if I draw a line that is parallel to line OA and draw a line, so it will intersect this stress strain curve at this point, which is called A dash. Clear? So I will write it at A dash. So now you can see that this will be the yield strength approximately. I will repeat, for a 0.2% offset, we begin at strain of 0.2% or 0.0020 inch per inch and graphically extend this line parallel to line OA till it intersect the stress strain curve at point A dash. So the stress at this point will be yield stress, and you can see here this is 68 KSI. So we can write that yield strength is equal to 68 KSI. Okay, now in second part we have to identify on the graph the ultimate strength and the fracture strength. So I will write ultimate strength, and we know that ultimate strength is the maximum strength that the material can bear. On stress strain diagram, you can see the maximum stress will be at point B, and this is equal to sigma u, which is 108. So I can write it, sigma ultimate comes out to be 108 KSI. And the last one is fracture stress. So I will write fracture stress. So the specimen is strained up to a maximum of, you can see here, 0.23 strain, and at this point the material fails. So you can see the stress related to the maximum strain, and at that point fracture occur. So this stress is fracture stress, and that is 90 KSI. So I can write it as fracture stress is equal to 90 KSI. And these are all the answers of our this example 3.1. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.